Hey folks, this is Noble Rambler, and welcome to another episode of Farming Simulator 17. We're starting today out here in front of Morgan's Massive Motors in our newly updated Massey Ferguson. It's fun just to say that. Anyway, let's hop out and take a look at this. We've got a Cultivate Field 13 today, and the Kuhn implements have arrived, and I wanted to see what is available here. Now, actually, let's go somewhere else. There's a sower over here. This guy, this guy. That not only sows the fields, but offers the possibility to seed directly, no previous cultivating or plowing necessary. He'll do all of the basic ones of the, like the green, little green sower we've got. Versus this guy, which does the other four, the sunflower and soy and what have you, corn. But this guy would cultivate field 13 and plant it at the same time. I'm thinking I want to go this route. Now, we'll also get into other combinations later. Probably not this episode. There's two major things I want to get done. But this group right here goes together. This guy goes in the front, holds the seed. This one goes in the back and does the planting. Got wheels that create a ditch and a wheel that fills it back in and a wire tying back here that kind of smooths it over. But along with that one, which is really kind of interesting, is this system over here. This acts as a plow, goes right behind the tractor. This acts as a cultivator, which attaches directly to the back side of this guy. And attaching to the back side of this guy is this guy with him in front. So all four go together as a set. Kind of interesting. So it theoretically, the whole combination doesn't need plowing or cultivating separately. The whole process is done at one time. So we'll pick an episode soon and get into that set and see how that works. Anyway, I also want to come back and get tippers today, but we'll get into that next. Did I actually buy it? I didn't actually buy it. Try it again. Oh, I got to walk up to it. I guess I got booted out. Try that again. Sower. Going for the Kuhn over here. This guy goes 3 meters wide, so 9 feet. Needs 110 horsepower, so really any of our tractors can handle it. Which seems a little wimpy to me for something that is a cultivator as well. That's a lot of weight to drag. He attaches to... I stared at this for the longest time before I started this episode. What is an AGCO 1100? I went through every one of these and finally gave up, went to Google, typed it in. I jumped out of there again and found it. Showed me a picture of one of these guys. There's an AGCO 1100. I wish they used names instead of just the model numbers. That would make life so much easier. Anyway, let's actually buy this time. All right, so right here and select. It is the correct one. Yes, 110 horsepower. Buy. And that one, did it give quantity? 2,500. Seed. Let's do this a little bit different than normal and just grab seed 1,000. Let's grab three of these. Now, unfortunately, this cultivator sower does not also fertilize. So we will need to head over here with our fertilizer. Or maybe a new fertilizer. Maybe we'll pick something that's a little bit bigger. And just something different. Kuhn has a couple of fertilizers, I believe, in this new package. All right. There we are. So let's go ahead and begin filling up over here. And we'll pull over to the other two. Actually, let's stop right there. Let's save that one, if we can. Thinking it's a little closer to the road and less... odd leaving it just sitting out in the middle, but yeah, probably doesn't make that much of a difference. We're going to use 2.5 of these. fact, now that I think about it, I think I took 600 out of that one, which means I'm going to actually leave two of them here. Oh, well. We'll come right back. We'll fill it up. Alright, just about there. Yeah, we left a little bit in each one. So much for that plan. That's kind of neat. Drops the ladder and to fill it up. Anyway. We're going to take this directly... No, we're not. We need to grab the larger weight. So let's do that. Best way out of here is right over here. Let's jump in the cab. A little noisy out there. I'm going to go for it. And you are far enough back to take this lane. Because we know what Maplefield drivers do on side roads. They think they own the whole road. So we'll take this in. Probably should take it in the front route rather than drag it through the fields. What does this look like from behind? Oops. There we go. So this front couple of wheels tear up the soil, cultivate it. The back section here does the sowing. Now these three fields out here are all owned by the same farmer. And we're pretty much close to 100% on him as well. So it wouldn't be inappropriate to grab some of or all of these fields here. Price is about as low as we're going to get. So these are a possibility as well. But let's go grab that weight and get up to field 13. We'll get that going enough to where we can trust a helper to finish it. Then we're going to come back and figure out how best to get barley to that great demand sale and get some of that sold off. All right. Best way to grab that weight. Which one was it? There's the bigger one. All right. You have any kind of a name on here? It's the Sawyer 1000. Okay. So I was recommending that one or the 1100. Off we go. So I took a peek at the great demand, and this time it actually is a good price. It's much higher than all the rest of them. Didn't work that well with the sugar beets. You know, just barely. And there was another one that we just skipped completely because it wasn't worth it at all, but this one is definitely worth going for it. Now, we could actually do both of these, now that I think about it. Tell you what, to keep this guy from accidentally sowing the other section, let's kind of do two or three rows right here at the divider. I think that will help. Let's put grass in this one. Let's see here. Why am I not showing that? Because I'm on the weight. There we go. So you are wheat. There's grass. So pull forward a little bit and let's see how this works. Let's hire it out. Am I close enough? Actually, I'm not comfortable with that. Let's take it one wheel off. Alright, I like that better. Alright, hire you out and watch what happens. He drops the cultivator in. And it's chewing up the soil pretty good there. Back over here, these wheels. Let's go to this side. Oh, that's a little better. So these front ones are cutting a little ditch, and seed is dropping in the middle of that with those hoses. And then the solid wheels back here are kind of covering it back over. And then the metal tines are just kind of stirring it all up. All right, let's see what happens here. This will actually be kind of a curiosity. Oh, has completed. All right. Not even going to attempt to figure that one out. Okay. That's fine. I just want to create a quick little buffer here. Something like that. Hire you out, and I'm going to hire it just because the rows are so much straighter. Still get to watch the equipment running. So I think two rows here and two rows there. Then we'll head over to the building over there and clean up that end. Alright, unhire you. You were heading back to that site, weren't you? Uh-huh. I'm gonna sew right over the top of the other one. Well, maybe not. Maybe you're turning right to go left. That's the way they do their U-turns. Okay, I'll give them the benefit of the doubt. All right, you are going to be what? Let's think about this. We've got Sunflower going into 9 over there, the skinny one. We Sunflower this one as well. They would both be harvesting near the same time. I kind of like that idea. Let's do that. So, wait a minute. This one won't do Sunflower. Never mind. What will he do? Let's run through the choices. Wheat, barley, and canola, and soy. Canola and soy. Canola and soy. There we go. Otherwise, it'll do oilseed, radish, and grass. Okay. So, soy we are herding on. That seems like a reasonable place. 1700 now. We sold that at 14. We saw the 15 and thought, oh, we got to get back in there and do that. Now it's 17. Wow. Missed the boat on that one, didn't we? Here's the about 800. A while ago that was 799. It's dropping. We got to deal with that one soon. Okay. So we're losing every few minutes, we're losing another dollar. All right, so soy it is. Let's go over that one. Back. And let's see why. It was on soy, wasn't it? There it is. Okay, hire you out. Yeah. Yeah, I could try and drive that one, but I wouldn't have the freedom to come back over here and look at things because I'd be constantly trying to steer and I'd do nothing right. It just wouldn't work out. Well, there is one thing to show you. I'll try to remember before we leave this area. These little arms over here, you know, this little flower-shaped disc at the end. When you're doing it manually, you can knock one of them out to the side. It'll leave a mark in the very center of the next row so that when, as you're driving, you'll know exactly where to steer your tractor at. In fact, let's give that a try. Let's do that. Let's run it ourselves for a little while. Right over here. That's pretty good. Okay, pull it back. I want to F1. That is a Z ridge marker. Right there. And then I want to. There's no unfolding. So V drops it down. And B turns it on. And drive. As long as we keep the first row straight, it's going to leave a mark right where we need to be for the next row. So we'll give that a test. Now as you turn around, you're going to want to hit Z once or twice more to pop out the other arm. We're doing okay back here? Yeah, that's looking good. Now on cultivated soil, it's much better. You can see that line much clearer. Right now it's an awfully big, wide line. Okay, B, V. Interesting. B pulled in automatically. Okay. And I suppose I can't just make a hard 180. I'm going to have to go around the block here a little bit. So theoretically, yeah, if it was on cultivated soil, you'd be able to see that much better. So C, you just kind of keep dead center to that line right there. So V, B, go see. There we are. Got to talk my way through that. But like I said, in a cultivated field, there'd be a much thinner little mark there. It wouldn't be so broad. But on a plowed field, we don't have the distinction of all the tiny little lines. Now, theoretically, we're doing pretty good here. Okay. But we'll head down to the other end, do the same thing over there, create a buffer, a headland at the end, if you will. And right there, BB. And then we can turn the hired help loose. He won't get into the triangle and he won't get into the building. We'll just do all the middles, then we'll come back and touch up whatever it needs to be. Alright, a little past. And when we pull in, it should straighten everything out. Something like that. Let's see here. Yeah, we'll do it ourselves. VB, go, and see. Nope. I'm going to keep it outside right here. I want to be able to see. Oh, I didn't do that. Z. There we go. Missed that step. I'll try to engage the edge of the grass there. Make sure everything is fairly even. Got to remember, I've got the V and the B on my mouse. So I can do that from here. There we go. I'm going to go a little beyond. Tuck in. Too far. There we go. Right about there. And Z. There we go. I see. I veered a little, so my line is veering a little. But we'll make it work. So, the sewed area is just touching the top left of my right front wheel. And kind of go by that gauge, too. Not a lot of turnaround room here. Not without driving into that other field, which doesn't feel right since we don't own it. Alright. Looks good back there. Oh, I love all the view of these bigger tractors. Look right down there and see what you need. I'm thinking two more ought to buy enough room for the hired hand not to hit the building. Not a lot of room at the edge of this one. You see what I mean when you use the plow to extend your field out to the furthest extents, you really take away your ability to do some turning around. Sometimes that's an issue. Not always, but sometimes. Let's hire this one out. Drops everything in and goes. That way I don't have to think about straightness. I can just sit here and enjoy it myself, along with you guys, and talk and not worry about multitasking and doing everything only halfway. So I had to go all the way out to here with the plow to keep the plow from hitting the building. This isn't as long. Maybe two more will do it. Let's see what happens here. You're probably going to drive in the other field, aren't you? Because you don't hold any allegiance to other farmers. Well, if we get a good rain or something, that I'm sure those tracks will kind of disappear. didn't do any damage. So, our tippers hold 15,000. The next tipper up, I think, does 21,000 liters. So if we get two more of those for now, I think we would be able to haul enough in to make the trip worth it. So once we get the hired hand working this direction, then we'll run over there and do that. All right, one more trip. I think I'll say that I can trust the hired help here. I think there's enough room there now to make that turn. Let's go one more. Interesting, it backs up a little bit. I don't know what that's about. I wonder if the angle it comes in, backing up, would actually straighten it. If it's a little bit beyond in one direction or another. Huh. I still want to take that one tree out right there. And think about a placeable in that area. Maybe the park can leave some equipment for this area. I'm not sure what equipment I would leave. I think about that. I mean, over in 3 and 4... Well, let me finish this job here while I'm talking, instead of talking. But over in 3 and 4, you want to leave all of the sugar beet and potato equipment over there, if that's the only place we're going to do it. But I can't think of what we would do here unless this is all sunflower. And what was the other one? Corn. I don't know. We'll see. Anyway, hire you out. We're still doing soy. Good. We're going to run him through one complete set here and see how he handles both ends. Now, I've noticed that it doesn't hit the edge of the row perfectly. The right edge there leaves some holes. I would imagine, though, there's enough overlap to make sure that's never a problem. I'm guessing so. We'll verify that too when he goes by. I want to see the distance that he makes here on this. She makes. He? What are you? You are a he. Alright, what do we got here? So by this already being sowed, he made the turn far sooner. And when's he going to drop the sower back into the ground? Right over here where we are within this field. Okay, that worked out fine. And we are overlapping a little bit. So that should take care of all those little missed spots. Alright, that's working well. We'll only use 6% of our seed, so we should be able to do the grass as well before we leave this area. Now, that little missed spot covered up perfectly. Okay, good. Now, we'll kind of eyeball how far out this U-turn happens up here compared to the building. See if there's anything to worry about, or we can walk away and know that this is going to get done properly without any missed spots. Alright, are we going to miss anything right in here? I know the sower didn't actually get to that area, but there's no discoloration. Oh, out here? Yeah, we're fine for the building. So it counts it even though the end tines didn't actually make contact. But it looks pretty good. We'll go back later and look at the chart and see if everything is showing light green, meaning that it's planted. But we're good here. Let's grab Uber and dive back over to Warrior here. Yeah, this is Warrior. And let's not carry this bucket around everywhere that we go. Let's rearrange things a little bit here. There we go. And let's... Oops. Backwards is forward, and forwards is wrong. Okay. This way, straight in, centered, and then dive off to a corner. That's the idea. Right about there, and correct one? Yeah, cute. And oops, and that's not the correct one. All right, let's turn him around. All right, same idea. Straight in, We'll put the big size stuff over here. And something like so. Okay, swing you out. Drop you down. Oh, it's hard to get a good angle here. Am I going to clear? Now we will. There we are. Like so. Alright. Not quite the right angle. Not the one I wanted. Let's come in more like this. There we go. Alright, so that is the correct one. Drop you off. And that's the right forward. The wrong forward. The right reverse. Alright, let's run out to the store. I like the sound of this one. It's got a good sound to him. Good engine. Sounds like it means business. Still working on getting used to the steering. Especially after driving the other one, they're all different. They all have a slightly different delay when pressing the key to turn right or left. Or how they react when the accelerator's down. Oh, it's good nobody stole the seat over here. Next episode, I have a feeling we're going to be finishing that off. All right. Let's go. Hello. All these quiet little hellos that pop in from the sidewalks. They seem to be in a little better mood after yesterday and... Or is that today? Today in-game. Yesterday in real life. Tippers. We've got these guys. 15,000. We've got two of them. Had this one. Dolly front. Tough backing up. Can do it, but tough. I like this style better. I want to get into... Probably this guy is the next step up. Eventually we'll get into something more, you know, significant when we're harvesting. When we buy field 5 and have 3 harvesters running at the same time and carting these beasts back and forth on, oh, the IT runner system. Now, how big are the IT runner grain containers? 45,000. That's significant. 59, 56. So getting into this range here, what are you officially? You're a Joskins. Why? Oh, is that glass? Maybe that's glass. Maybe so. This is called a grain container. This is a HT50. Same available or use, you know, items that can be used in it. But I wonder. Because you'd think it'd all spill out. Unless that's glass as well. Anyway, I am getting distracted here. This guy is a dolly. This guy is not. He will attach to himself, I'm assuming, and the HDK302, this guy, and the DB8, this guy. Don't know why he wouldn't attach to all the rest of them. Unless this tongue is much longer than this one and it needs that. Could be. That looks longer than that one. But that's the one we want. We want two of them. Select. Ooh, we get choices. Well, then let's go more toward a Rambler green. Yeah, I think so. Wheel setup. Wide tires. Standard tires. I don't know. And the design is white. I'll probably the lettering right in there. White color. What does that mean? White and color. Let's buy color. I'm not sure. Buy, yes. Okay, and let's do one more. I could buy one of each. And we'll see the difference. Buy, yes. And then we can also, at our own maintenance shack there, we can change it back, which depending on which one we like the most. Back. Has to do with the white K? Or none? Huh. Okay, well, a little different, but not enough to be worth really being concerned about. Okay, let's grab these guys and go fill it up with barley. Close enough? Well, take that even? No, I don't think so. Let's do that. Oops. And let's do it wrong and do it again. There we go. Go a little further. One more. Recover. Ooh. Almost look like I know what I'm doing. Then I do that. Okay. Let's try that again. Now I want to go this way. There we go. Where am I hooking to? Oh, he's clear down underneath. Looks like it's a lot closer than it is. Is that going to be close enough? No, I think my alignment's off too much. All right. One more time. There we go. You really don't want to connect, do you? Wow. It really does require a dolly front. I just assumed they would connect together, but it wants a dolly. Interesting. Okay. Well, I guess we're going to have a spare trailer to leave off at a at another field somewhere. Let's leave you right there and pick up the other one. So you really do only connect to this guy and that guy because you want a dolly. Okay. Yup, Rambler Green, and, well, doesn't matter, bye. Dolly, over there. Okay. Now, I'm hoping I've got the right one in front. It seems like it'd be the right one. There we are. Now it's happy. Now, I am correct that these are both the same size. 21, 21. Okay. All right, let's go do this. And I'll come back and pick up that other one and find a home for it. In between episodes, so it's not a distraction next time. But we've got our first official train going here, and I'm going to make the guess that I could hook up a third one of the dolly at the back end. So that has to probably assist with the steer or the turning. Maybe it'd be too rigid. They have two of these other ones in place. Now I've got the speed to go around this guy. Depends on if there's any left hand or any people coming off the side roads and turning right in front of us like that blue one would have done. I can get around these guys. Yeah. Helper B has completed their task. I don't think so. And I was supposed to make that turn, wasn't I? Okay, we're going the front route. And I think we'll grab a quick Uber and find out what's wrong with Helper B. That shouldn't be. Alright, I'm gonna take this from in cab. Alright, off on the gas, swing around. Yeah, control it much better from in here. Open fun to watch the trailers make that corner. Actually, this is where I want to go. Okay. No, it's not. Let's try that again. We want the other side. Okay. Helper B is right there. What is with you? So you kind of freaked out on me, huh? Yeah. I don't have a clue. So let's just get him going again. We're still on soy. Take it in a little bit far right in there and hire you out. Alright, you seem to be doing okay. Alright. So, boy, I tell you, these Uber bills are really starting to add up here. There we go. And R? Yeah. Then what? Y? Oh, I could use my mouse. Okay. Barley, start. Well, that dumps fast. That's interesting. It's not counting them both combined this time. That's how I'm used to seeing the trailers act. And start. Huh. I had to think about that. Maybe because they're not identical. One's a dolly and one's not. That might be what's going on. Now, where are we going? This is at the Denton Bakery. That's in town. Oh. That'll be a little interesting. Denton Bakery. Right there. Okay. So, back route? No, front route. And first left. Okay. And I can get out this way, right? Yeah. And we'll watch the trailers make the turn this time. They all move independently of each other. Coast is clear. Let's go. There's a little weight on here this time. Yeah, I am having trouble hitting 30. These guys all drive at about 30. That tells me that I can probably sneak in front of that blue truck. Oh, I'm going to have to anyway. It's time to make my turn. All right. Right there. Now, down my little mini-map. Shows me turning back behind there? Might be. Anyone behind me? Doesn't appear to be. Authorized vehicles only. That sounds like me. There we go. Alright, take it nice and wide. You guys, I can't get a view in the mirror. See? There we are. We're good. So could I do this only by mirror? Probably not. Unfortunately, the mirrors don't show me everything that I need to see. I can get this guy in. But I won't really be able to see far enough around him to see where the next guy is. Anyway, F1, G, that takes me to him. And I want to unload from the back? Sure, we'll do the back. So put you right there. And unload is you? I. Oh, unload and forced unload. Gives me both choices in there. Okay, so I? Yeah. Now if I go to G now, what happens? Doesn't change anything. What's going on out there though? What? Yeah. So much to try and do it from in the cab. You just don't have a good grasp of what's going on. That's what I thought I was doing. Anyway, $16,608 last time. And how much did we lose in those few seconds? $16,606. Only lost $2. Okay. Anyway, there is about 32,000 more to add to the... in fact, that was the cost of the sower we just bought today. Ooh, that's kind of nice. So we didn't actually spend any money other than the two tippers. All right, let's put these guys back. Got to figure out where back is. Don't really have room right now in the garage for the trailers to add these guys in. As well, the third, this guy, you know, the other fixed axle of this size. So I'll have to think about that. May have to just park them outside for the meanwhile. All right, coast is clear. I think I'm just gonna leave it right out here for the moment. Yeah, let's GQ. Let's head over to the to field 13 and see what's going on over there. Kind of end this episode. I see I'm going a little bit longer than I would like to. Not much to cut out. In fact, it's going to be kind of hard cutting things out the next few episodes, as we're going to spend a lot of time with new equipment and exploring, so not a lot of repetition coming up. Let's pop over there and see what's up. Well, seems to be doing a good job. Tell you what I'll do. I think I will just end the episode right here. And when I get... I'll just continue recording. We'll do another episode, kind of starting from the middle of this field and see what adventures we can get into next. So this has been Noble Rambler. Thank you guys for watching. And hit the subscribe and like if you would. And I'll catch you next time, folks. Bye-bye.